I'd like to call to order the January 11th regular board meeting of Lawrence Bruce Public Schools. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Happy New Year. It's going to be a great year. We've got wonderful kids, we've got staff that are uncompared to Michigan, and we've got facilities that will support our students and community, and it's going to be a really, really good year. There's a couple things. We have monitors in front of us, so if you see us looking down, we're trying to follow the agenda. And we've had some issues over the last couple months, and it's starting to work a little better, but still, we have some interesting things that are scrambling up here when we're looking down. If we close, let's say when we go into presentation today, that pushes us back out of the program, we have to reload it. So those things are, so we'll be a little confused, a little more confused, but that's just the nature of things sometimes. During the presentations, this is video and put out across our network and other public airways. And if for any reason you have a student or somebody that you don't want to be on the video, just let us know. We'll try to make sure that we remove that. It's just something that you should know. I'd like to start with, is there a motion to approve the agenda for tonight's meeting?
Roll call.
Oh, I'm sorry. Roll call.
Ada. Mrs. Odell?
Yes.
Mrs. Marmer?
Here.
Mr. Gruber?
Here.
Mrs. Hudson? Mrs. Fletcher?
Here.
Mrs. Ross? Yes. Mr. Gruber?
Here.
Six, yes.
We have six members present. We do have four. Now, for the approval of tonight's agenda, is there a motion?
Make a motion that we approve the agenda for January 11th, 2016, as presented.
Support. We have a motion with support. Is there any discussion on the motion? On favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Approval of the minutes. Is there a motion to approve the December 14th regular board meeting minutes?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Support.
With Shannon. Right. We have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion on the motion? On favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. And also, the way we're doing this now, we have the December 17th fall board workshop minutes. Is there a motion to approve those?
Make a motion that we approve the fall board workshop held on December 17th, 2015, as submitted.
Is there a second?
Support.
We have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion on the motion? On favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. For the presentations tonight, I appreciate your coming out on such a cold night. Board Member Hilton is going to address the Hornberger, sorry. Hornberger is going to address the community on that. And it's not my name. So please, we'd like to proceed with the presentation.
October through May, the Las Cruces Board of Education recognizes students that exceeded the expectations of teachers and of the administration. Tonight we have, I believe, five or six students, unfortunately, are students from Collins that I was unable to attend. But I would like to introduce LCHS Associate Principal Alicia Williams to make the first introduction.
Honored to have this opportunity to recognize two students from Las Cruces High School this evening. To start us off, we have one of our veteran PE teachers, Mr. Brian Lorenzo.
We thought we'd bring along a visual aid here.
Thank you, Lisa. This is Christian Palka. I had an opportunity to coach Christian in a couple of different sports, football and lacrosse, which are both represented on a little poster here. You can kind of hold it up so everybody can see. I was hoping to make it a little bit bigger, but this is the best I could do. Some other things about Christian that I think everybody should know. The Navy SEAL there in the corner, he will be leaving to join the Navy on July 5th. So I think that's a very positive thing for him moving forward. Also, a little pizza here is not because he's a big eater. He works a part-time job delivering pizzas at Papa's Pizza, so that's why we included that. Kind of stole a page out of David Letterman's book there, the top five reasons why Christian Palka is student of the month instead of the top 10. But number one, always helps put away the equipment after class. As you can see, he's enthusiastically putting away the volleyball standard. Number two, has very good attendance. Three, likes to participate in class. Very enthusiastic. You can see some volleyball action down there at the bottom. Strong leadership qualities. He helps out a lot of the other kids in class. He's a good role model to have for the other students. And last but not least, always willing to be there for a friend. As you can see, he's hanging out with one of his buddies there, and he's going to be having a pretty good time. So those are the reasons why Christian Palka is the PE student of the month.
Thank you once again for giving us the opportunity to do this and carry on this really great tradition, opening every board meeting by recognizing their best and brightest. I have the honor of introducing Mr. Richard Stump this evening. He's our automotive collision and refinishing instructor. You can come up, Rich. Rich also is an instructor at Baker College, two nights a week teaching the exact same course. He's an avid snowmobiler, he and his whole family. One interesting thing I learned about Rich 10 years ago when I first met him is that he is a lover of speed, not just vehicles, but a snowmobiler. And you think he was involved in racing snowmobile, but not on snow, not on ice, not even on water. He raced them on quarter mile concrete tracks. And if you don't think that's insane, the next thing that he told me was, if he's in a dead heat with his competition, he can get 2 miles an hour faster by simply putting his head down and watching the lines go by. Anyway, it's right to start.
Hard-working student for me for the past 3 years. In our class, we always seem to have big projects that take a lot of time and a lot of effort, and they seem to never get done. Not many students have the work ethic to see the project through to the end, and they struggle and stay motivated, but not these. He is an excellent role model for other students to follow. No matter the situation, I don't think I've ever seen Reese display a negative attitude. This obviously carries over into other things that he does. Reese has 60 community service hours, well above the required 40 hours. Reese currently works for Mike's Tree Surgeon in Troy, and they have an apprenticeship program that is with Oakland University. He plans on getting his degree at Oakland University and then returning and working as an arborist for Mike's Tree Surgeon. So, and then he'll work full time for them. It has been a pleasure having Reese as a student the last 3 years, and I'd like to wish him well, and he'll be greatly missed next year. Reese is here with his parents and his girlfriend. Do you guys have a comment?
Next, representing West Reese High School North, Dr. Greg Nixon.
Good evening. We have two outstanding staff members from Crusader Nation tonight to present to our exceptional students. The first one is Mr. Kiner, who joined me at the podium. Anthony is a multifaceted staff member. He has his hands in a lot of different things. He's quickly become a mentor and role model for our students. He's our head coach for our varsity football team, but he's also in the home economics department, what we used to call it, now it's life skills. And one of the things students enjoy most about his cooking classes are the cook-off challenges that they have. So he brings a lot of things to the school, and not only do you see him in football games, he comes to our basketball games or volleyball games. He's in the hallway between classes, he's at the front door each morning before school, and we truly appreciate the leadership he brings to Crusader Nation. Mr. Kiner.
I have with me today Jenna Andrade, I said that right?
Yeah.
Awesome. And her family, which thank you guys for coming. So really in life management, we look at it kind of the whole life and what makes you successful in life, and Jenna really does hold all those true. The first thing about her is she really cares about others. That's hard to find sometimes nowadays, and really sparking that interest in other people around you. And she, every day she comes to class, you can see the kids around her really spark up and enjoy her company, so that's an awesome quality to have. She also, Dr. Dixon talked about her cook-off, she also takes risks. It's hard to find the students that want to take risks and go that extra mile. I believe you guys made sushi rolls out of pancakes, which was really awesome. Actually, we put a little strawberry in there with Nutella, wrapped it in pancake, made a little sushi out of it. So it was really cool. Not everyone would take that risk, but she understood that that risk could be taken and moved to the next round. So really, really cool. And then the other thing is her leadership in her group. It's really hard to find leaders today and really take on that role of making sure that everyone's doing what they do, and she does a great job. And those are the reasons really why we selected her. And she's also a hard worker in throughout the classroom, and we're really excited to, for her to be our Lansker's North Life Management Student of the Month. Thank you.
He has shown each and every day that he is a natural leader in the class. Not only does Kyle start off each choir class with a smile from ear to ear, but he brings a contagious positive attitude that spreads throughout the choir. Kyle is one of those silent leaders that we all like, always leading by example, giving 100% each and every day. If it's learning a new piece of music or going over music theory, Kyle is always attentive and eager to learn. He also is always one of the first ones to arrive at each and every concert, ready and willing to help with any last-minute details that need to be done. It has been an honor having Kyle as a student the past 2 years, and I definitely look forward to having him in the future. Once again, Kyle Crescenti.
We'll take a 5-minute break. Let's come back at 6:30.